Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Today's episode is brought to us in part by Woodcraft, helping you make wood work, and also by Whiteside Router Bits. Router Bits made in the USA.
All right, everybody, it is the beginning of a brand new month, and that can mean only one thing here at Matt's Basement Workshop. That's right, it is time for Router Bit of the Month! All right, once again, the great folks over at Woodcraft and Whiteside Machine Company totally set us up. They sent us a great router bit to try out here in the Basement Workshop, and for one of you lucky listeners, you're going to be winning one of these yourself. So I will make sure to announce who the lucky winner is at the end of today's episode. So what do we have? Well, for the entire month of May 2008, Woodcraft is featuring Whiteside Machine Company's shaker-style raised panel bit. And let me tell you something, this is a great router bit for anybody who absolutely loves shaker-style furniture. Because let me tell you, this thing just absolutely stays true to the straight lines, the simplicity of shaker furniture. Because really when it comes down to it, we're all familiar with what the shaker craftsmen have done. And really it's the simple lines, the attention more towards the actual material than it is to the overall design that makes shaker furniture so beautiful. And really, Whiteside Machine Company stays very true to it with the shaker style raised panel bit. So for the entire month of May 2008, if you are interested at all in picking up the shaker style raised panel bit, because say maybe you weren't today's lucky winner, well, you know what? Woodcraft is going to have a nice little discounted price for the entire month on the shaker style raised panel bit. And if you're lucky enough to have a Woodcraft store in your local neighborhood, you should head on over and pick it up. Because like I said, it's a nice discounted price. It makes it that much easier to add this to your collection without breaking the bank. But you know what? If you prefer to order from like woodcraft.com, I'll make sure to have links in the show notes at mattsbasementworkshop.com so that you can pick up one of these yourself and take advantage of that great price. Like I said, it's for the entire month of May 2008. So anyways though, the shaker style raised panel bit, what exactly does it look like? Well, let's go ahead and take, this is the one that the winner is gonna be getting. So I'm gonna go ahead and grab mine that I actually have and you'll see me use this. And basically, this is the shaker style raised panel bit. It is a big bit. I mean, take a look at that. It comes in about 2.5 inches in length. It has about a 2-inch overall diameter, has 1-2 cutters, and each cutter come in at about 5/8 of an inch thick. So given how big this bit is, you know what? This is one that you're actually gonna be using in your router table. Nobody is gonna be using this freehand. This bit is just way too big to be trying to use this baby freehand. It's a nice 1/2-inch shank, and this baby is really, really heavy. Now, one thing that we always have to talk about, we have come to expect to this all the time from Whiteside Machine Company, and that is the fact that these are carbide tipped cutters, and you can kind of get a close look in there. Those are some pretty thick pieces of carbide that they have on here. So number one, with it being carbide tipped, we know for a fact that it's going to be quite a while before we're going to need to worry about sharpening these babies. But given how much thickness there is, you know what, we've got quite a long time before we'll ever have to think about replacing these babies, because there's quite a few sharpenings in there if and when the time comes. Now, one more thing I have to point out about the actual bit itself is, you know, you see it right there at top. Man, there is that famous Whiteside bearing. I love these things. These things just keep on, you can cake them up with sawdust, you can do whatever you want. They just keep on spinning. I love them. They spin like they're on butter. And the one nice thing about the shaker style raised panel bit is there's not just one, there's not just two, but there are 3 bearings that come with this bit. So what you can basically do is you get 3 different router bits with just one, basically. You can swap them out, and I will demonstrate, I'll show you in a little bit when we actually go to make the panels, depending on what size bearing you put in, will actually determine the size of the shadow line around the actual panel itself. But, you know, I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself. So what we need to actually do now that we know what bit is going to be featured for May 2008, we know what it looks like, we have an idea of the overall size and everything. The first thing we need to actually do is to, let's see it in action. So what I'm going to do next is we're actually going to head over to the router table, and I've created a frame that I'm going to set these panels in. I'm actually going to show you how I cut the actual frames or the panels themselves. And I don't mean to spoil it, but the frames that these are going to fit in is a nice shaker style rail and style set that is actually going to be featured for next month in June. So the two really complement each other. So what we're actually going to do is we're going to head over to the router table, and I'm gonna show you a blank that I start out with, and I wanna show you a little technique that helps me to get everything lined up into the actual frame itself. So let's do that next. Okay, so before I actually get started on doing the actual raised panel. I just want to show you, here's the actual square itself that will become the panel, just making kind of a small one. And I like to actually have my panel so that it's centered in the actual railing style, so it's not flush. You could easily have it so that, let's say, the back is kind of raised up a little bit, but then again, the panel is going to be obviously raised also. So like I said, I like to have mine nice and flush. And so in order to do that, I'm actually going to need to make a back cut here that's equivalent to, you know, the thickness on either side. So I'll just take my style here and I'll actually mark where it is that the thickness needs to be that I have to remove from the front and the back, which then allows me to come over to my router, which is completely unplugged, and I can actually then adjust it, which is going to take a little bit. Well, we'll start there, and then that way I can raise it up to that finished height, which is probably the best bet. Because remember, we're removing a lot of material here. So the next thing we're going to do is to actually get this all set up to start removing the material, and we'll do that in just 1 second.
Okay, so when it comes to actually using the shaker style raised panel bit, I highly recommend that this has to be used at the router table. This is a huge bit. It should not be done freehand. And the nice thing about it is that you can set up the router table with feather boards, which are going to immensely help you to keep this panel nice and flat against the actual table surface so that you get the same exact cut all the way around. Now, when it comes to actually making the cuts, I always recommend that you start with the end grains, because there will be a little bit of a tear out. So when you go to the long grains, as I'm doing right now, it'll actually clean it up. What you could do is start with like an end grain, go long grain, end grain, and then finish up with a long grain. But most importantly, you really need to start at the end grains to get the exact look that you want, so that you don't have that tear out. And also, I'm working with a softwood here. If you were working with a denser hardwood, I would definitely recommend making multiple lighter passes. Now, since I've already finished up the front side, and as I had demonstrated when I was trying to get the panel so that it's nice and level with the rest of the railing style, I actually marked the back side. And again, I'm just going to use the actual shaker style raised panel bit here to do the back side. So I will have a matching panel both front and back of the door. And really, you don't have to do this. You can just simply set up a regular rabbeting bit. But you know what? I'm already here, and it works perfectly fine. It works great. And, you know, it's one setup, and it couldn't be any easier. And again, I just start with the end grains and finish up with a long.
All right. Well, as you saw, it was really, really straightforward. I start out with the blank, and really you have a couple of different options. You could have the panel itself sit a little proud of the frame, or in the situation that I described, I like mine being in the same plane as the actual frame. So that's why you saw me mark the top and the bottom. And well, here's the actual result. So this is the actual shadow line. This is a 15 degree bevel that we actually get from the cutter itself. And really, I'm just gonna turn it on an angle here. You can see that I did it on the top and the bottom. Now it's up to you whether you want to have, you know, basically the same bevel on either side. You could just simply do a rabbeted joint on the back, just put in a rabbeting bit and you could do it. But the way I saw it is, I'm already here and it's working fine. It's not removing that much more material than I would get from a rabbeted joint. And on top of it, when it comes down to it, and you'll see this towards the end, when I get my frame in position, I actually have the same exact profile on the front and the back. So when I open the door, I'm looking at the same thing. Otherwise, in a lot of situations, you could just have just a flat, undecorative panel in the back, which, hey, for a lot of applications, that works out perfectly fine. But you know what? It saved me, you know, that much more time by not actually swapping out and putting in a different bit itself. I just used the one, and I got it done in a matter of a few minutes. So what I need to do now is, the bearing that I actually used when I created this particular panel is the widest one. And I want to put in now the medium one, and then eventually I want to put in the smallest one, because I want to show you what all three panels actually look like. And when it comes to actually swapping out that bearing, it couldn't be any easier. I mean, really, when it comes down to it, it takes just a matter of a few seconds to take the set screw off, pull the bearing out of the way, and put the next one back on. In fact, actually, I'm going to show you that next. Now, one tip I do have, and I mentioned this in there, is make sure that you take and unplug your router bit. You know, we can't talk about safety enough. So anyway, so that's what I'm going to do next. So I'm going to show you how to actually undo the set screw and, well, basically swap out the bearing. Okay, now with this kit, there's actually 1, 2, three bearings that you can try to get different sizes for your panels. And basically what's going to be the difference is the reveal from the actual rails and styles. So I put the largest bearing on, and then what I'm going to do is use all three bearings. I'm going to make three different panels, and you'll get a look at all three of those. So changing it out is really, really simple. Use the included Allen wrench, and make sure you can get a hold of the actual bearing, the bit itself without cutting yourself, because these bits are very, very sharp. So we're going to go ahead and remove the nut here. We're going to pop this bearing off, and I'm going to put the next size down. And like I said, I'm going to run three different panels, and you'll get a look at all three of them when I'm done. I'm going to put them all in the same exact frame, and I'm showing my wife and decide which one that she wants to use, because we're probably going to redo our kitchen cabinets, and we definitely like the shaker style look. So that got nice and tight. Again, look at the bearing just keeps on spinning. So what I'm going to do is run this one through. Again, it's a little bit smaller size. It's going to give me a little bit more reveal, and like I said, you'll see that at the end. And before the end of the episode, I'm going to run the third one and the smaller, and then we'll see what that looks like. All right, so was that not easy? I mean, seriously, it was just a matter of a couple of cranks, pop that baby right off, and just put the new one right back on. So anyways, though, I just want to show you really when it comes down to it. Okay, here's the widest one. You can kind of see the lip. Just take a look at the lip, and then I'm going to show you the medium one. Doesn't look much different, does it? And then there's the smallest one. Now you might notice there's a little bit more meat around the actual lip. Now what I'm gonna do right now real quickly is I'm actually gonna pop them into that frame that I made so you can get a better idea of what it looks like. And my suggestion is when you look at these, you will notice that they kind of look very, very similar. The shadow line is very, very slight. So if you're not sure which one you really wanna use for your project, my suggestion is start out with the largest bearing on there, so it's gonna remove the least amount of material. And then basically, if it's not what you wanna go for, so maybe you think, all right, well, I would like a little bit more of a reveal around this corner. Well, then you know what you do? Pop on the medium one, which I'm gonna show you here in 1 second, and then you'll just remove a little bit more material, and you'll get just a slight more reveal. I mean, there's a little bit more going around the corner there. I mean, you can kind of see there's just a little bit more of a reveal right in here. The panel seems to be floating a little bit more in the center. But let's say, it's not enough. I want even more reveal on there. I want that field really floating in the center there. Well, then, again, just simply pop off that bearing, put the smallest one on, and we now put the smallest bearing in place. We'll pop this right in, and there you go. Look, you really can see a bigger difference here. The panel seems to be floating in the middle. The field seems to be floating more in the middle. So when it comes down to it, you know what? If you can't decide which one you want to go with, start with the largest, go to the medium, and then to the smallest. And that's how you can determine which one you want to try. And you know what? It works fantastic. It looks great. And I'm going to have to talk to my wife about maybe redoing our kitchen cabinets with this baby. So anyways, though, that's pretty much it. All right, folks, well, that is really all there is to it. When it comes down to it, the Whiteside shaker style raised panel bit helps you to create just fantastic looks like this great panel right here. And this one is with the smallest bearing. Remember, like I said, with the three bearings, they help to give you three different size panels. So really, when it comes down to it, it's almost like getting three bits for the price of one. And it couldn't be any easier to get fantastic results like this each and every single time. So, for one of you lucky listeners, I had mentioned at the beginning of the show that you're going to be winning a great router bit from Whiteside Machine Company. So congratulations to Ed Veneers. Congratulations. You are this month's lucky winner. And of course, you know what? If you didn't win, but you want to win some swag, or you want to maybe get some of that free Safety Week stuff that's going to be coming out pretty soon, which starts actually on Monday, May 5th, you know what? Drop us a line at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com, and that's where you can drop your comments, questions, suggestions, any kind of feedback that you have. I love to hear from everybody. You know, as I said, mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com, or stop by the website at mattsbasementworkshop.com. And if you're not Ed and you didn't win the router bit of the month this month, well, you know what? We've got more coming up. We've got more swag coming up and everything else. But if you really had your heart setting on getting one of these great shaker style raised panel bits so that you can make panels just like this, you know what? Head on over to woodcraft.com. I will have links for it in the show notes. Or, you know what, if you're lucky enough to have a Woodcraft store near you, definitely head over there and pick it up. So I think that is pretty much going to do it. You know what, I got quite a few more of these to make, a little bit larger than this one. So I think that's what I am going to do. So until the next time, I will be talking to all of you. Straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.